Now we will work on conflicting, contradicting, complicating desires. I gave the example in the morning itself. My headache should disappear. Means what? You are strengthening the headache. The ichcha sakti, desire energy, should simply become creativity, kriya shakti. It should not have any perversion. It should not have any self-contradiction. Only then you will be attracting wealth in your life. Otherwise, see, when your ichcha shakti, if it is not simply becoming kriya shakti, you will only have more and more tiredness in the life. Tiredness is sin in the cosmic law. Tiredness means what? Not having inspiration to live. Not having inspiration to be. Life is an action. Life is an expansion. Constantly expanding from ichcha shakti to kriya shakti is life. We will work on the self-contradicting, conflicting, complicating engrams. Let us first dig out them, then we will get into the kriya. Please write down all the desires you have related to money in all three forms: yearning, spending and saving. For each of these desires, identify if you have any conflict. Clearly describe the conflict. Means you feeling like one time like working, other time going and lying down in the beach for vacation. Make a list of conflict-free desires you have in all the aspect of wealth, earning, saving, spending. It's a very powerful workout. Please do it. I wanted to tell you some of the basic truths. Anything you plan with your mind is conflict. Now that is the truth. But you need to understand by you working inside. If I tell, that is not going to work. Anything you plan in a complete silent inner space is planning. Now all I am going to do is give you literally a break from your mind. By giving you the break from your mind, infusing more consciousness and awareness inside your mind, please understand, all these words will become now really meaningful to you. Means your mind as on now is almost like a fish market. I am going to bring it down to a jewelry shop. Fish market means extraordinary chaos and conflict. Jewelry shop means little organized. Spy cameras are there. And the people who come there also has to be dealt decently. People who are standing to deal, they are also a little decent. Because too much money is involved. The receiver also has to take care of you respectfully. And person who spend, he will also be responsible. I am bringing the loudness and chaos of your mind to a lower frequency and raising the silence and awareness of your mind to higher frequency. So naturally, less conflict, less contradiction, less complication, more creativity. will start the kriya. Please understand, basically this kriya infuses tremendous creativity in you by bringing peace and silence and awareness, breaking one of your powerful blockage. We call it hridaya granthi, powerful knot which constantly creates fear and complications. Breaking that, bringing awareness. Please sit in vajrasana. Vajrasana means sitting on your knees. If you feel you won't be able to sit in vajrasana, you can sit in ordinary siddhasana. First, warming up. Bastrika. Bastrika means use your lower abdomen muscle to pull and in, like pull in and up. Please do it for 3 minutes. Stop. Next, Sheetali, please understand. Roll your tongue like a tube. Roll both sides of the tongue like a tube. Stretch the tongue and roll it like a tube. Roll both sides. Inhale through the tube. Let me show you. When you are full, hold. Hold as long as you can, then exhale as slowly as possible. Inhale like a tube. Hold. Hold as long as possible, then exhale as slowly as possible. Do this for 7 minutes. This will bring tremendous healing energy into the body. Restful awareness. Please do this Kumbhaka. Close your eyes and do it. Protrude your tongue. See, first stretch your tongue out. After that, then roll. No, nobody is doing properly. Please open your eyes. First, show the tongue. Now, in the tube, inhale. Don't relax your tongue. Let the tongue be outside. Yes. Only after inhaling, pull the tongue inside to close the mouth. Hold as long as you can. then exhale. Again, protrude your tongue before inhaling. Make it like a tube. Do this continuously. Step. Please understand. Now the Trishula Kumbhaka. Through both the nostrils and the mouth, inhale simultaneously. Let me show you. Once you finish inhaling, hold as long as you can. When you can't, exhale as slowly as possible. Do this for 7 minutes. Understand? Inhaling through both the nostrils and mouth simultaneously with closed eyes. Close your eyes. Let's gather for next session. Thank you.